Hi guys, by the end of this video you'll have mastered three different ways to present your beautiful Canva slides directly within Canva. I'll also show you how to add transitions between slides for a smooth and really professional touch. In case you've not visited my channel before, I'm Nikki Pasquier and I'm a Canva certified creative. So if you want to learn how to successfully market your brand online using some of the best digital marketing tips, tricks and tools, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn that little bell notification on so that you're one of the first to know when I publish a new video. We've got a fair bit to cover today, so let's dive in. Righty-ho, so I'm on my Canva desktop and I've got a copy of a presentation in front of me. Before I start, let me just quickly show you how to add transitions to your slides. Make sure that the slide you want to transition from is on your Canva desktop. Now go to the top left-hand corner of your toolbar where you'll see the Animate tab. Click on it. If you have a free Canva account, you have the benefit of 7 transitions to choose from. Canva Pro users will have an additional 7. Just click on each transition to see how it works and test out, see which one you prefer. Personally, I like to keep things simple and use either pan or block. And I keep the other transitions like pop and neon for things like fun GIFs and other animations. If you have a lengthy presentation, you have multiple pages to save you a heap of time, just select the transition you want and apply it to all pages by clicking in this little tiny box right here next to the text Apply to All Pages. So turning now to actually presenting within Canva, all the tools you'll need are within this button right here. And one obvious thing to mention right at the start is that you will need to have an internet connection to present within Canva. So I'm just going to click on this Present button. And you'll see that there is a drop-down menu. If I click on the downward arrow, you'll notice that there are 3 different modes to present your slides in. There's standard, there's autoplay, and there is presenter view. So let's start off by having a look at the standard view. So I'm just going to click on the present button to go into standard mode. Now, standard mode is particularly useful for workshops, small groups or one-to-one training where you can simply share your screen with a smaller audience. It's also perfect for presenting your screen for online webinars via Zoom or StreamYard. And here's what I absolutely love about the standard present mode. You have a little inbuilt presenter tool for your cursor, which is perfect for pointing to and highlighting various parts of your slide. So let me take you down to the bottom right hand corner of my screen. And there, I don't know if you can see, but there's a little toolbar, a presenter toolbar. From left to right, I can restart my presentation right from the first slide. I can see which slide I'm on as well. So here you can see I'm on slide 1 of 23. And that's pretty handy if you're on a timed webinar and you want to keep track of your progress. The next tool here gives me the ability to open my slides in presenter view. And we'll talk about presenter view in just a few minutes. The next tool is called Canva Live, and it's a really exciting new development which has just been launched. I'll show you exactly how to use this a little later on, so do stay tuned. And the last tool enables me to exit the full screen. To transition between your slides, you can simply tap a key on your keyboard, such as the spacebar, or you can use these side arrows right here. And you can see how effective the little transitions are when I click through to the next slide. Let me just exit the full screen mode now. I'm going to go back up to present and I'm going to show you the second presenter mode, which is autoplay. And this is really, really simple. If you want your presentation to simply run on its own without you having to do anything, all you need to do is select how many seconds you want to spend on each slide. And this is pretty tricky actually, because this will apply to all of your slides. So you'll need to know your timings extremely well. To change the amount of seconds you spend on each slide, just pop your cursor in this box here and then type in however many seconds you want per slide. So I'm just going to show you how this works. I'm going to type in 3 seconds per slide, click on present. I'm just going to sit back and watch this change all by itself. You see how that works? I can't really see anybody using this mode because, as I say, you really have no control over the speed at which your presentation runs. Now, the third and final way to present slides within Canva, click on Present and go into Presenter View. Now, this mode is absolutely perfect for live conferences or meetings where you have the use of two screens or one screen and a monitor. The reason for this is that when you click on Present, you have two windows that are opened up onto your screen. You have the audience window, and behind that is your own presenter window. So on one screen, you'll have the audience window, and to open it up into full screen mode, I just need to click on this purple button here. And this is exactly what your audience will see. Let me just minimize that down to the bottom. And this is your presenter window. This is what you will see. You have the current time. Moving across the screen, you have a timer ticking away, which is really handy to help you keep pace of your presentation. You can start from the beginning by clicking on this button here, and that will reset the timer. To start the timer, simply click on the play button. On the right-hand side of the screen, you can add your notes, and you can use up to 2,000 characters here. Right at the bottom of your screen, you'll have little thumbnail images of your slides. If you're speaking at a conference, no doubt you'll be using your digital clicker to transition between slides. If not, you can still transition between slides by clicking on these side arrows or clicking the thumbnail image underneath. Now let me talk to you about Canva Live, and this really is very exciting. If I just click on the button right here, Canva Live lets your audience join from any device and allows you to crowdsource questions. So what exactly does that mean? If I click on the Start New Session button, I can now invite my audience to click on canva.live on any device that they're using, so their smartphone for instance, and enter this particular code. So let me just do that for you, just to show you exactly how it works. So I'm going to enter www.canva.live, and I'm going to enter the code that Canva gave me on the previous screen. So 476457, 476457. And this is what your audience will see. They will see that they've joined the PA Forum Talk handout, which is my current presentation. And to type in a question or a comment, they just need to place their cursor in this box here and type away. Okay, hello Nikki. And you'll see my message has popped up on this side screen right here. Unfortunately, Canva Live is a Canva Pro feature, so if you want to experiment with this feature, why not click on the link which I'll leave in the description box below and treat yourself to an exclusive 45-day free Canva Pro trial. So that's how you present slides within Canva using Canva's three different presenter modes. Be sure to check out my three other Canva presentation tutorials and all my Canva tips and tricks to help you market your brands online. That's all coming up on the end screen in just a second. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to be taking a short break for Christmas and New Year, but I will really look forward to seeing you again next year.